Okay, Davis Cup final and the crucial match with Sampras in total control. Two sets to love up, number one. Andre Agassi there, supporting the team. I just wonder, having looked at Andre there, if he wished he'd made an extra effort. And perhaps played, even though, because I gather he's not injured now, but...
Well, he has been injured, and he hasn't played for several weeks.
I think that's the crucial thing, that he hasn't been playing.
Right. He wouldn't have been Andre Agassi if he had played.
Well, it just occurs to me that if he hadn't pulled out, we wouldn't have seen Sampras playing singles. What a pity.
That's true. I don't know exactly what Tom's plans were, but I heard that he was thinking of playing Andre and Jim in singles and Pete in doubles.
I think that was the plan.
The original plan. Yep.
A good bread and butter pass, really. He should have made it, but there are so many occasions in this match where he's been faced with that sort of situation and hasn't made the pass, hasn't watched the ball. Did you see Pete Sampras earlier today?
What
mood was he in?
No, I didn't. Not today. I had the other day, but today I didn't.
The first really key point against Sampras in this match. Didn't last long.
Well, that's what Pete's ability is. He gets a big serve when he needs it. That's what's so incredible about his talent.
It's his stock in trade, really,
it
isn't it?
Is.
Faced by a tough point, one serve, it's over.
He's able to do that time and time again.
Kafelnikov is looking a different player. In fact, he's looking like Kafelnikov should look, and has so often looked in the past. Very dangerous.
This has played Pete done a couple of times in the last couple of years, and I'm used to seeing this.
Yeah, I bet.
So Vince was competitive, but the same type of thing was happening. When Pete needed the big serve, he got it.
Good pass indeed coming up from Kafelnikov here. Had to play the ball slightly late. Therefore, that particular angle was just about inevitable. Played it well. Oh. great shot. The off backhand coming across the ball. Just a little bit of side spin on it as well.
That's Pete's game, is really taking risks. You need to take risks and pull them off. And I really think the game has played too conservatively today.
He's had one deuce last game of the second set. Only 5 points dropped in all in the second set. Only three in the first.
What else is new?
So out of the four break points, three, two have been aces and one unreturnable. And that lovely backhand.
But Yevgeny, like you said, is looking a lot better. He's much more, it looks like he's going to be into this third set.
So team morale has been terrific all the way through, as you've seen, Vince.
Oh, yeah. Yep. Yeah, very much so. All the players helping each other out, practicing, coming out for extra time.
Yep. Good points from the net.
This is the way Kafelnikov can play now. He just seemed to be not into it the first set, especially. And he has a tremendous respect for Pete. Great respect for Pete and everybody does it. He just knows how great he can play, and I think he was maybe a little intimidated just because Pete was on the court.
Livid there. I've noticed Sampras hasn't in fact smashed very well here. I think it's got something to do with the lights. They're very bright and they're right up where the lob is.
Right.
Most stadiums
the players
have them on the
side. During the practice expressed some concern with
lighting. Did they?
Yes, they did. All of the players during the practice. So you're absolutely right about that. They don't see the ball as well as they'd like to.
Well, I'm quite glad to hear that, Vincent, because I've been saying that. Hardly blame Sampras. I know Kafelnikov has come on a pace in this third set. You can hardly blame Sampras for just relaxing the tiniest bit.
Not a good idea, of course.
Not a good idea in any match.
Never. How well you can play. If Kafelnikov, it's over.
I'm sure. Well, let's be critical of Sampras for once. Spent a lot of time praising him. That was not a very good shot, and it's given away the fifth chance to break. Second time on break point, Kafelnikov has had a second serve.
But it just didn't help this time.
The five break points. And win or lose, this game has put a different complexion on the third set.
From the Russian point of view, I think Anatoly Yelichin has got to probably be telling Yevgeny if he can keep Pete out there the longer, he could possibly somehow tough out this third set. He's still in the match, because over a long match,
absolutely,
anything could happen.
Third chance of a second serve break point. Wasted. Vincent, thanks a lot for joining us. It's been nice having you on Skype.
First time we've had an opera singer, I think, in the commentary booth as well.
Well, you should have sung.
Maybe later on, Vincent, thank you. But I thought that was like Custer's last stand. I really did. I think if Kafelnikov had come back there and got a break, then the roof would have come in for a start, and anything could have happened.
Almost booing Sampras for having the nerve to get to this final shot, but Kafelnikov, I'm afraid, goes the wrong way here. Across the body, and Sampras will dive.
Yes, I would say that for the last 10 minutes, as much as anything else, it's been the crowd testing Sampras' temper.
Well, if you can come through Lyon and the French in 91 and the noise they were making. It's in.
Yes, I think the point was he didn't come to Lyon, did he?
No, but I just mean he experienced it,
yes,
is what I mean.
Yes.
No, he did not come through it.
So certainly there's a little bit over exuberance, possibly even a little early vodka. One of the spectators run just beneath our commentary booth.
Sampras doesn't need the luck, but he's had it. Just a quick apology there.
Got here for the third time at game point, and don't forget he had 5 points to win the previous game on Sampras' serve, so it's a totally different match at the moment. It's just that the United States are two sets up. Good.
I think one of the major differences in these two players is the quality and the speed of the forehand. Oh. Sampras is hitting very, very hard on the forehand. Kafelnikov, I watched this morning practicing, was hitting equally hard in practice, but has not transmitted that onto the court. And that is one of the major differences between these two players here.
May have abated. United States break. Lead 2 sets to 11, 2-1.
Yes, well, I think Kafelnikov is very much more competitive than he has been in the match so far. I personally am very disappointed with his performance, not his. Nobody could be disappointed with the way Sampras is playing. But Kafelnikov has not, by any means, nowhere near, in fact, done himself justice. Well, this could be Kafelnikov's main chance, in fact, an injury to Sampras, which, of course, he... was stricken with at match point, if you weren't watching the dramatic ending to his first singles match against Chesnikov. Sampras collapsed with cramp at match point. So that could happen again, in which case Kafelnikov would be the winner. And that would be against all reason and justice, because he's being demolished so far in this match.
The last two games, Sampras holding his serve after 5 times being a point from having it broken, and then in the last game when Kafelnikov 3 times held game point on his own serve and then had his serve broken. The last two games, it seems to me, might well have been the final pulling down of the battlements. I don't know. United States 2 sets to 0 and 2-1 here with the break. Will you go and clock him, or shall I?
There's a lot of rival laughter going on.
Every time Sampras misses a ball, well, they're just beneath us.
Fueled heavily by vodka.
Yeah. Thank you. that was close judgment by Sampras. Could well have fallen out.
Yes, he elected very early to ignore the fact it might have gone out and play the shot.
2 points for 3-1. That's 3-1 and two sets to love, and that might be an unassailable lead. Change of racket. And once again, there's still around this place. We had 15 minutes or so of hiatus.
Less risky, of course, to serve to the Sampras backhand. He should do that more often.
Yes.
Very sophisticated shot, that.
Our noisy friend just below us was ready to acclaim that.
Yes, he was indeed, yeah. But he omitted to notice the fact that this was top and side spin, and that bent it around Kafelnikov like a penalty.
Point for 4-1. Which is what Sampras has been doing quite spectacularly.
Very quick action, that serve. Slightly lower toss than usual.
United States lead, and taking their break, and a lead of 2 sets to love. Just to give you an idea of the enthusiasm for tennis here, yesterday Bill and I were talking to Leah Pericoli, who's here, the former Italian player and now broadcaster. She played an exhibition somewhere in this city, yesterday or the day before. And one of her opponents in the doubles was a Russian astronaut.
Apparently quite a good player, apparently.
And one of the other players in the four was the lady coach who coaches President Yeltsin.
Yep. And the fourth member was Nikki Pietrangeli, the man who has played more Davis Cup ties than anybody for Italy.
Now, what is Anatoly Lepushin thought to say to his young charge? He didn't coach him from the start. It was Kafelnikov's father who first took him on a court, then he had his own coach in Sochi. Some chants going up. They're trying to get a chant going for Kafelnikov. I don't think enough people really believe in him in this situation at this moment. And I'd be among those, I think, were I in the crowd. 3-2.
Well, I really do think that's worth a look by Sampras. Looked good to me.
And by Bruno Rubio. Given the serve, good.
And I'm sure Kafelnikov knew it was good as well. So Sampras with the first serve again. Well, when he tries to take the ball a little bit earlier, as he did then, he's been far more successful getting it at the top of the bounce or even before it's risen. Let's see how early he does take it. He's on the rise and he steps over it. Very good return.
Sampras, like a man in a position now who's got one eye almost, but not quite a firm hold on the summit of the mountain. And he knows that it needs probably just one more heave. The moment they hesitate and suddenly it becomes too difficult. The admirable Bruno Rubio not just calling the score and making the decisions.
just when he thought it was never going to happen. Three games low.
Sampras has been tugging away with the off forehand, cross court there, and you can see what that's done to the crowd. It's woken them up in a big way. Sampras broken for the first and only time. Kafelnikov with a love game to underline the break of the Sampras serve for the first time. And that puts a very different complexion on this set. And in fact, the whole match, of course. Sampras absolutely cruising with a 6-2, 6-4 lead. And from then on, just a slight relaxation of effort or concentration and an increase in the Kafelnikov effort has resulted in us being now back on serve. Russia 4-3 ahead, having served first. Kafelnikov himself has had two love games in this set. And Sampras has been struggling on serve for the first time in the match. And a very much more perky and alert looking Kafelnikov coming out now.
We wondered where all those red, white, and blue new Russian flags were, but we've seen them at the change of ends. And there's had to be a special announcement, appeal made over the public address system, that people respect the players and don't shout when a point's being played. Service, unless he loses the rhythm, is the thing I think that's going to hold him on here.
Sampras treating this service game like a very fast court. Decisive volleys, good serving. Effortless game by Sampras, and this final volley showing how comfortable he is around the net. Just holding the racket out there, angling the face of the racket, getting the ball over. Kafelnikov nowhere to be seen. Four. very difficult to see up there in those very bright lights. And it was a terrible smash and punished very well by Kafelnikov. Suddenly the seeds of doubt must be being sown here in Kafelnikov's mind. And they are getting very excited. And Sampras really giving away 2 points with those awful smashes, but I'm sure it is something to do, normally very good overhead, but I'm sure it is something to do with the fact that it's difficult to sight the ball up there. If it's hit down the middle of the court, where there is a very bright line of lights, two lines of lights, in fact. And it would help, I think, in the future if they could have the lights more from the side, but it's such an enormous stadium and so high, really, that there have to be an awful lot of lights up there to light the courts efficiently for play. And they're a long way away. However, Kafelnikov had a good first serve percentage, but not serving anywhere near as many aces. But that one crucial break back by Kafelnikov has given him hope. And Sampras doubts in his mind now that it's going to be quite as easy as he thought after the first two sets. There have been three absolutely key games for Kafelnikov in this set. Second game, where he had five chances to break Sampras, didn't make it, but it gave him a little bit more hope, a bit more conviction. Then when he broke especially, and here this is 4-5, Sampras serving. Well, even then he went down the middle of the court, but it was the timing of the overhead was much better. Yes, that one was slightly more to the side of where the lights are. And I don't think he would have been blinded by it.
Matches on clay court this year has Sampras, though he really has the game and increasingly the understanding and patience to win on them. Yeah. He's taking his time down there, thinking this through. I think that's what's going on. I was about to say that I just have a feeling that his win over Chesnikov on the first day, where he didn't really play that fluently at all, Sampras, and yet won.
Yeah.
I think that might have been a victory of enormous significance for him on clay courts generally.
I think another factor that might be in Sampras's mind is that he does not want to stay out there too long. He's had a busy couple of days before this, a very long singles, then all the tension of the winning doubles, and of course a cramp problem in those legs you're looking at.
Yes, marvellously played, his natural instinct to attack, a player of great daring. Five games all.
Lovely little incisive, like a scalpel cutting across then, that volley. Exemplary technique, five all. He's changed his tactics since his match with Chesnikov as well. He's playing the off forehand to get Chesnikov deep on the backhand side and then going for the forehand instead of that dangerous hook from the backhand side.
Well, it's good for him that he hits winning shots from that position. Was at the US Open, there was one in particular, the wide running forehand cross court.
Oh, a sensational shot, I can see it now, yep. Yep. There was another one in the Rome final, I remember, against Becker.
He serves not just for this rubber, but for the Davis Cup. Because it would give the Americans a winning lead of 3-1.
Very well played indeed by Kafelnikov. Move well to it and control that pass beautifully. Because Sampras played the whole point to win from the net, but he couldn't reach that.
Kafelnikov had started the match, played the first two sets with anything like this emotional backbone, this would have been a fantastic match. But I don't think you can give the number one player in the world a lead of two sets to love.
Well, he hasn't got a very good record in five sets, Kafelnikov. Won two and lost three.
Yeah! And that's the break. All the Americans. back and the support team and the players up on their feet. It could be just now the final thrust to be made by Sampras. 6-5, and he's going to serve for victory for America.
Yeah, it's quite a heady moment, isn't it, for Sampras, for Tom Gullickson, for the American team and for American tennis and the country in general. They're, of course, right at the top of the league, the United States of America, in Davis Cup history, having won 178 matches and lost 50. Russia is way down. America started in 1900, first match, beat Britain. And Russia, having only started in 1962, are 22nd in the league, but they're catching up fast. 150, lost 28. But somehow, I can't see Sampras, even with what we've seen in this set, which has been very competitive indeed. Kafelnikov playing very much better, and Sampras not quite so well. One fact having a bearing on the other there. I just can't see Sampras coming out here and not taking the glittering prize which sits on court there.
Now, early this year in the spring in the States, Sampras here and Andre Agassi got together and they talked each other into giving everything to make one enormous bid to win the Davis Cup for the United States this year. And he's 4 points away, is Sampras, from doing it right here as he serves for the match and for the cup.
Let it be said also that Agassi has a marvellous Davis Cup record and has been extremely loyal to the United States team.
Yes, the hand's gone out. Took a long time.
Difficult shot, actually. High. And he looked a bit loose playing it. Not his best shot, the high backhand put away.
Forehand volley, it was a sitter, but I think he was very happy that it cracked away there. The timing, not perfection.
I just wonder if we're going to see a change of tactics in the tiebreak, but both players might try and attack more. One. couldn't resist going for it. Took a lot of nerve. Yes, it did indeed, Jerry, because it's a shot which he has really avoided playing a lot in this match. He played it all the time against Chesnikov, not always successfully. He's been very patient with the off forehand cross court. 2.4. Well, that's killing luck, I think, against Kafelnikov. That is really tough. That shot going well in till it got the net cord.
Or two, United States.
It suddenly occurs to me, Bill, the first time you and I ever did a commentary on Kafelnikov playing a really big match was, go on.
9-7, fifth set, second round, 94, Australian Open at night. Dramatic.
And he was magnificent, Kafelnikov, the way he just stood and eyeball to eyeball took on Sampras.
Absolutely marvellous match. Marvellous. He was 2 points off beating Sampras.
4 points to 2. Third set tie break.
Our vodka friend enjoys every Sampras fault, doesn't he? To the full.
It's a terrible return. Oh, a pretty awful serve. 5-2. States lead in the third set tie break after Sampras had served for the match and for the cup. When he served for the cup, he didn't get a point in that game.
What a moment in any tennis player's life. Wherever you are in the world game, number one or number 100, you're serving for the most famous trophy in tennis.
Edge of that sideline, the shooter.
Well, the tension mounts because this is Sampras' last chance on serve. Isn't that point?
Do it, and I have to say that in the end it's been Sampras who's done it. He's done it by winning the first singles, most difficult match against Chesnikov, then by coming in at the last minute and playing the doubles with Martin and winning that as well, and now by beating Kafelnikov.